comfort zone, no matter if you want to sing, dance, paint, you know, play an instrument, whatever. You just have to take that first step and try. And right. then it could open so many doors, no matter what you're doing.
That's true. Sometimes you take a step in one direction, mm-hmm. and that's what it does. So what I want to do is wish you all the best at Miss America.
Thank you.
That myself and our viewers will be cheering you on. Tell us about the videotape and what you can find online at Miss America, mm-hmm. because each of the 53 contestants,
yes.
promote themselves with a video or a DVD. Tell me
yes.
about that.
Well, the Miss America organization has offered America's Choice, and it allows America to vote one contestant into the top 15.
Okay.
So each contestant had the opportunity to make a video, to talk about themselves, why they should be Miss America, and they haven't posted the videos yet, but they will be online soon.
Okay.
And you can vote for your favorite contestant, and hopefully, maybe me, we'll make it into the top 15.
All right. So what we'll do is we'll make sure that information's online.
Yes.
And that way they can find you and we can vote for you.
Yes.
So one last thing I want you to do, if that would mm-hmm. be that would be good. So you do talk shows as a living. I want mm-hmm. you to convince our audience to contact me to be on the show.
And contact why. You?
Yes.
Okay. Well, this is a great opportunity to get yourself out there and to network to the community. And so being on All Friends Cabaret is a great way to express yourself, to meet Christine,
and
to have the opportunity to have some fun and be on television. So why not? Come on. We're having a great time here, and I'm sure that all the folks out there would love to come on too.
Oh, wonderful. Well, Taylor, thank you so much for coming into the cabaret.
No problem.
We really appreciate you taking the time. And good luck at Miss America. It's
thank
really
so
going to be
much.
a wonderful experience for you and to meet all the people out there and to just open many more doors.
Yes.
I wish that for you.
Yes.
All right. Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you so much.
So now we continue our show, and what is exciting about it is we get to see talent. The Miss America organization is all about talent. Most of the scoring of the Miss America pageant, talent is the highest scored by the judges. So tonight we have Maine's national sweetheart, Kelsey Early, to clog for us. And she was in the Miss Maine pageant this year, and we'll talk to her afterwards. But I present to you Kelsey Early. Kelsey, come on over and sit down. Catch your breath. I have to catch my breath after that. Welcome to the program, and
thank you
for dancing. I'm gonna let you sit and breathe for a minute so
okay.
you can catch your breath. So my story on our route to get you onto the show is a fun one. So I have volunteered, because of my involvement in the Miss Maine organization, I have volunteered at the pageant. So our marvelous instructor, Bill Early, who's worked here for many years, I was leaving one night and I said, "Hey, Bill, I'll see you later. I'm going to the Miss Maine pageant." And he said, "My niece is in that." And I said, "Oh, okay. Well, I'll go and say hello." And I said, "Also, well, not only was his niece in it, she got second runner-up, And you won a swimsuit award. And what else did you win?
I also won the community service award.
Okay, that's great. So I came back and I gushed to Bill. Oh, your niece did so well. So you're here on the program. So what does it mean to be Maine's National Sweetheart? And what I have here is your sash.
Yes.
It's really quite beautiful. It has a little court. You can explain that. How does one become Maine's National Sweetheart?
Well, we all, you have to either be a first runner-up or a second runner-up. And for mine, I was a second runner-up, and because the first runner-up was too busy.
Okay. So what they do is they have a competition that's much like the Miss America competition for the first and second runner-up all over the country.
Yes, so you have a representative from each state, and we all travel down to Hoopeston, Illinois.
Oh my gosh, so was that fun when you got the call like you were going?
I was so excited that I had the opportunity because I didn't think I was going to be able to because I got second runner-up.
Okay.
So when I got that call, I was all excited. I like ran in, got my mom together and everything like that, and we're going.
and then when was it? Over Labor Day weekend?
Yes.
Now,
yes.
Do they award scholarships in that pageant, or is it just for the experience?
For the experience, yes. And there was, I believe there was a scholarship, I think it was like $1,000.
Okay, for the winner.
For the winner,
Because what they do is a lot of women that perform in the past, they'll go on and win their state title. Like I know some Miss America winners were National Sweetheart winners. Like I believe Leanza Cornette was. She was Miss Florida in the 90s. But she had, it's like a training ground, right?
It is. It was a lot of fun. We went through rehearsals and everything like that. And for that whole week that we were out there, we were treated like we were royalty.
Okay. Didn't they have a parade for you as well?
We did, yes. And we almost got rained out.
Okay.
And the community all together was just like, no, we cannot go a year without this parade. So we all got in convertibles and we all were out there waving. And just the support throughout the whole community was wonderful.
Oh, that's great.
It was really
great. That's great.
Yes.
And then you got to compete instead of against 12 women. How many were there? 53? Was it
no,
all the...
There was 40 of us.
Okay. That's great though.
So it was very close to the 52, but yes.
Now, so let's get back to your roots in Maine. Are you from Maine? Are you okay?
Yes.
And so how long have you been competing in pageants?
I have been competing for 4 years.
Okay. And so has it always been
the America
Miss America
program.
America program?
Yes.
And what do you like most about it?
I really like the talent and how
you shine up there. But you like the talent.
Yes. And I also love to have a platform.
Okay.
Because
and what is your platform?
My platform is literacy.
All right.
Yes. And it all started because of my father who struggled with reading. And I was volunteering at our literacy program where he was going. And together, it's been like a family bond, and I just got more people involved. And
oh,
it's just been a lot of fun. So I really like that and how other people can express what they really like and be involved with the community.
There's a real big volunteer aspect to the program. And so you're studying, what are you studying in school?
Dental hygiene.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
So tell me about your clogging.
Yes.
How did you start?
How did I start?
Probably a very young age, I'd imagine.
I was 4 years old. I was actually in the audience watching my sister up on stage because I was too young to dance. So, and I said I wanted to be just like her. So the next year, my mom put me in, and ever since then, I just fell in love with it.
All right. And so we were talking earlier, too, about the difference between, I would think clogging, I asked you, do you tap? And you said no. And I thought, oh, well, isn't that the same thing? But they're very different. Tell me the differences.
Okay, well, one most important is the shoes. We have similar shoes, but the taps. Clogging has like a jingle to the tap. We don't have a solid tap. And so it has a different sound to it. And we also dance to the downbeat of the music. So it kind of, and we lift our legs more high and everything like that. We have more arm movements, I think, too. But I think very similar, it's similar to a tap.
Okay.
To compare.
And so do you practice often? Like, and you said you're a part of a team. So tell me about that.
Yes. I've been a part of a team since I was 4. I was on the competition team. So we
travel. And how many are on one team?
Well, it varies. We have different age categories at our dance competition. But on ours, we probably have at least, there's around 15 in each category. And we've been just traveling to Vermont. We've been competing in New Hampshire.
Okay.
And we actually travel down to Tennessee. And
oh, fun. And is that like a national competition?
Yes, because it's very popular in the South. Because when I say I'm a clogger, everyone's like, what? You know, not too many people know about it.
Not too many people. Yeah, so. It's like, oh, okay. I mean, you do see, and I've seen it before, but it's probably not as big followed as down in the South. So it's four of you on the team?
There's usually 14 to 15.
Oh,
at least.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. So do you all get together and practice?
Yes.
Is it a yearly competition?
Yeah, we have at least one that we all go to every year. So we usually practice once a week. Sometimes if we need it, we kind of pull another Saturday practice, you know.
Okay. So how flexible. Have you balanced your time between, say, school and prepping for a pageant? How do you manage your time?
Well, I'm very busy, I can say. I actually have a part-time job, too, so I have to balance that in there. I definitely make sure I stay organized, you know, make sure you have a time scheduled and everything, my phone, my calendar, I have everything in that.
Synced.
So, yes.
Synced up. Oh, my gosh.
Right.
Well, on the All Friends Cabaret, I encourage my audience members to come on and be a part of the show. How would you encourage someone to try something new or to get involved with volunteering? What would your words be to them?
Yeah, I would definitely tell them to try it and don't be afraid, because you never know what you're gonna get out of it. Mm-hmm. And I actually have had a wicked fun time here.
Yeah,
and it's been
good.
A great experience.
So
yes,
glad.
And I think it would be wonderful to get out here and show voice what you have to say and everything.
No, that's good. Mm-hmm. That's good. So tell us, you're not hanging up your sash anytime soon,
nope.
right? Are you going to
nope.
compete for Miss Maine again next year?
I am.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
good. That's so great. Well, I thank you so much for being on the program.
Thank you.
What I want to say to my viewers is contact me. Believe it or not, All Friends is not only on Facebook. We are now on Twitter. I don't know how to use it, but we are on Twitter now, so follow us on Twitter. Contact us at the All Friends Cabaret. And Kelsey, thank you so much for coming down, sharing your story. It's neat because I don't think a lot of people, they know about the Miss America pageant, but not so much about this, you know, kind of a training pageant for everyone. And I think that's so great. They do so many good things.
Yes.
And they're developing great leaders. So
it's great.